Oh, okay.
No, it's all 75% travelers. So
yeah.
They've gotten much more patient and better at teaching.
Okay. That's awesome.
Got blades, 1, 2, 3, 4.
4 blades.
We got checkpoints, 1, 2.
2 checkpoints.
We got hypos, 1, 2.
2 hypos.
We got bogey tips, 1. It's your boy, the surgical guru. Today, we're gonna give you a basic setup for a Mako total knee. So, our doctor right now, he's bouncing room to room. He's got a couple of these scheduled for today. And we're just gonna walk you through the setup, the before and after. So you can kind of see what that looks like. Drape out this little table over here. Kind of use it just for some extra space. You might not end up leaving it, but it's nice to have extra space when you're setting up. Just to keep everything organized. Let me pull this right here. Thank you. All right. So we're gonna grab the trays and get that on board. We gotta make sure that there's no holes in the filters. So that's why you gotta wait, give it a second, and let your nurses or your helpers check and make sure. Take me a second here.
think you need most of them.
You don't need any of that. This is our suction irrigator. Take off the strings this morning.
Can you guys do me a favor?
What we do here. And also our, what's this thing called again? Aquamanus.
Aqua.
Yeah. That in there. Here. Hey. I appreciate your appreciation. All right, so just to get it out of the way and put my drapes up there. We can start really getting this together a little bit.
How's it going?
That's great.
Kind of just getting things together now.
Got here some grass on the ground? You don't want
it? Yes.
You think we should open up another
one? Yeah.
I didn't think so. Towels over here. Thank you. actually tells you on the package which one is the sharp. You can see here, this is for the sharp one, and that's for the blunt one. We just usually just look where the ends are and make sure there's no silver showing. To the base array and the knee femoral array. That's right here. Checkpoints in. Pull down here, right in there. Alright. Usually I usually put right back here. Just grab them when you use them. Put these two trays together like this. Yeah, so he likes the ones for the spike for soft tissue, right?
Yeah, I mean, that's good. I usually put up the one with the spike and the duck. He calls that one the duck. So that's without the spike, ferrous mint. So they're both ferrous mint with the spike and without.
Okay.
He would use the one without for bone.
Okay.
And the one with the spike for soft. But typically he's only been using the duck bill and the spike.
And the spike.
Yeah.
I keep this one down here. I'm gonna pull this. Put this like right over here. And we do that at some point. We start out with the Gelfies, right?
Nope, not the Gelfies. We start out with the wrist and the wrist.
Give him a towel,
mm-hmm.
and he'll hold the leg up, and the nurse will then prep the foot.
Okay.
Then he'll put a 3/4 drape down underneath the leg, and then give him the stockinette and the coping. Then there'll be the two U-drapes, the plastic U-drapes, and then the small piece of that IO band.
The small piece that we cut off?
Yeah. Then the big extremity sheet. and you'll have one extra three-quarter sheet for the opposite arm. So you'll have knee one over here. Then I'll take the skin scribe and mark his incision, and then put the big IO band on. And then you're ready to go. Then I'll do his timeout, the last to the clamp for the bed,
yeah,
and put the positioner on. And then the boot. The boot will actually come before the positioner,
okay,
with the green toe band. And when he starts, he'll make skin incision.
Yeah.
Dave and Mike will take the rakes and the rich.
Okay.
Then he'll want a sponge to wipe off the quad. He'll mark the quad. And then I'll take the heat knife. And I'll take off some of the fat pad. He'll elevate the medial side. And you'll give him one of the 45s. And then the little cob. And then the other 45. Then I'll take the fat pad off the patella, and you'll give Dave the snatch.
Snatch.
And then the two towel clips, he'll do the patella. So you'll need the caliper and the saw.
When does he the lamina squared?
Near the end. After he finishes the patella, he'll put one of those protective caps on it.
Yeah.
And then he'll go straight to putting the arrays in. He'll take the 11 blade. Dave will take a snap.
Yeah. After the 11 blade?
Yep. And then you'll give him the tibial power, the short one.
That little funky looking one.
The two little, with the two little tubes on it.
Okay.
Just make sure it's the 4.0 and not the 3.2.
Okay.
He'll take that and then the two short pins and then the tibial array.
Two short pins and the tibial array. And then he'll take...
Then he'll take the two long pins. He'll go up to the femur.
Yeah.
Actually, he'll put in the tibial checkpoint. He'll finish that down.
Right.
Then he'll go to the femoral side femoral checkpoint. The two pins with the longer power, and then put on the femoral array.
It's like pins, checkpoint, pins.
Yeah. Yeah. Then after that stuff is done, you know, it'll register with, that's when you'll use your sharp and blunt probe.
Yeah.
It'll register on the robot and make his plan for this cut. And that's really the hard part.
Yeah.
You know?
And pretty much like...
Then after he pulls the robot in, he makes all the cuts, he'll clean up at the end.
Yeah. It's pretty much like...
Yeah.
That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you prefer robotic knees as opposed to regular knees, or which one do you like better?
I do like the Mako.
I think the Mako is more straightforward.
It's more straightforward, and
I think it's better for the patient.
I think it's more repeatable.
Yeah. I agree with that.
I like to, as a tech, I like to do both.
Right.
I like doing regular knees because they're a little bit, keeps you a little bit more busy, you
right.
know?
Right.
A little bit more challenging.
I did regular one with Mitch yesterday.
Yeah, he moves fast too.
Oh my God.
Sure.
Especially me?
Yeah.
I was struggling a little
bit. It takes
bit.
A while for you.
Yeah, it takes a while for
get me. On his pace.
But he was patient with me though.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he...
He's good.
Yeah, he was really... I had nothing to complain about him.
It's gotten much better. Because...
Yeah, I think he got
the environment of the OR now.
Oh, okay.
No, it's all 75% travelers. So
yeah.
They've gotten much more patient and better at teaching.
Okay. That's awesome.
One, two, three, four, five.
For 15 miles.
All right. blades, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Four blades.
We got checkpoints, 1, 2.
Two checkpoints.
We got hypos, 1, 2.
Two hypos.
We got bovie tips, 1. And